QFirm Remote Backend is one of the latest features of QFirm. It is equivalent to Terraform Remote Backend. Basically, in Terraform and also in our QFirm, there are two types of backend. One is local and another one is remote. The default is local backend. In this case, the resource state is stored under the spec.state of the QFirm resource YML. Using a QFirm remote backend, we can store the resource state in cloud buckets and can use it further from that stored location. It allows the use of a shared storage space for resource state. Multiple users can use the same resource using the remote backend. The resource state can be maintained remotely as we are storing the resource state in a remote backend bucket like Google bucket, Amazon S3 bucket, and etc. Now we can use local or remote backend and can even switch from local backend to remote backend in the middle. QFirm supports almost all top cloud providers bucket as remote backend. And some of them are given here like S3, GCS, Azure, and many more. Let's see a diagram to understand how local and remote backend works. Initially, QFirm controller is installed in the Kubernetes cluster. Now let's say a user came and wrote a QFirm resource YML in which under the spec.resource, he has given the resource configuration. As he didn't provide any backend ref, spec.backend ref, that means he wants to use a default backend, which is local backend. And after applying this configuration, our QFirm controller will reconcile it and create or update or delete the respective cloud resources. And when the reconciliation is done, QFirm controller will store the resource state. Basically, state is the real world state of the resource, which we get after the creation or update or delete that operation. And that state will be stored in the resource YAML under the spec.start field. It is when the user use a local backend. Now, if user want to use remote backend, then he needs to give the configuration of remote backend in a Kubernetes secret, and it need to be referred under the spec.backend ref field. And now after applying this, QFirm controller will again create, update, or delete the resource as like before, but now QFirm controller will not store the state under the spec.state. Rather, it will store the state in the given cloud backend as a remote backend. And then anyone who have access that bucket can access that state file and can use it in, from anywhere or any machine. And this is how local and remote backend works. Now let's see the Terraform and QFirm configuration for remote backend support. This is the Terraform configuration where a Linode instance resource is basically using a remote backend. In this specific case, it is S3 remote backend. And in the resource block, you can see the resource configuration is given, the region, image, level, and root bus is given. In the provider block, the Linode credential is given. And in this backend block, the backend bucket configuration is given. Here the bucket name, key, region, access key, and secret key is given. Here basically it is referencing that the in a folder named QFirm, and under that a file named terraform.tf state, the state should be stored on that file of our AWS S3 remote AWS S3 bucket, which name is QFirm remote backend. So this is what it is saying. So this is the Terraform configuration of a Linode instance resource, which is using S3 bucket as a remote backend. So now we are going to see the exact configuration in a QFirm resource YML. This is the resource YML where under the spec.resource, the resource configuration is given, which is exactly same as the Terraform resource block. Here only the root bus, which is a sensitive field, is not given. The root bus is given in the secret ref secret. And also the Linode credential is given in the provider ref secret. And the termination policy and update policy are the two features of QFirm. Here termination policy is delete, update policy is do not destroy. And you can see in the spec.backend ref, Kubernetes secret named backend secret is referred. In this is the field of remote backend bucket, where remote backend bucket configuration of a secret which is hold which stored in a secret, like here in this case it is backend secret bucket secret, and the configuration is given, which is basically S3. This secret need to be referred under the expected backend ref. So you can see the name of the root backend bucket is S3, which is exactly the same, and under this S3 field the configuration of that remote backend bucket is given, which is also exactly the same. And this configuration needs to be in JSON format, and only one bucket is allowed, can't give more. So this is the exact comparison of Terraform and QFOAM Resource YML configuration. And these two, both of them works exactly same. This basically works in the Terraform and this works in the QFOAM Resource. Now we will see the demo of QFOAM remote backend in our next video.